Hello, hello, hello to my tremendous review channel. I'm going to be honest with you, folks. There's a lot of weird movies coming down the pipe. So I needed to relax with a nice family film. I searched through the 289 movies on my computer and found one. Sam Irvin, a director of a bunch of full moon movies. Oh, joyous, joyous day. Our movie begins with Zachery Ty Bryan from Home Improvement upset that his mom canceled their date. Apparently he was gonna go on a date with his mom.
Cortland, you know, wants me on the Griven account, which means I've got an 86-hour meeting.
It wasn't a meeting, Mom. It was a dinner and a movie.
Oh, come on, Jack. This could be really big. If Griven likes my pitch, honey, I could be in for big money. I mean, bigger than your dad ever made.
Worried about money and how she's going to provide for her son, she leaves him in the care of her live-in Hatian housekeeper? How does she have a live-in housekeeper if she's that worried about money?
Jack and I will not be going out tonight after all, so maybe you could just fix
him dinner.
I know. Huh. Looking in your crystal ball again.
And that, ma'am, is racist. Just because she's Hatian doesn't mean she has a crystal ball and magic powers. She totally ends up having magic powers, though. Because, of course, she does.
A book.
Not just a book. This story will change your life. Sure as it did mine.
One night, my great-grandmother caught me running off for the circus. And she took me to her room and she gave me this book. Say it'd be in our family for over 200 years. I don't ask much of you, Brian. But I'm asking you now, before you take off trying to escape all your problems, read a few pages. Who knows? Maybe your problems won't seem so bad come tomorrow.
So, there is a map after all. And you swear on your good mother's
He, of course, is sucked into the book and falls from the sky straight into action, where the good guys save/capture him, thinking that he's a sorcerer, because he did fall from the freaking sky, and can help them find the treasure and navigate Magic Island.
Who are you guys?
Prince Morgan Hildebrandt, adventurer extraordinaire. And this fetching lass is none other than Gwyn Lighton, the best swordsman in all of Ireland. Oh, of course, Dumas, my most able guide and scholar of the Caribbean.
Where am I?
Surely you've heard of the Magic Island?
Well, looks to be a treacherous path to Klobas's tomb. For the closer we near the treasure, the stronger this isle's magic will be.
Yes, thank you, large Hatian man who in no way will end up being related to his maid in a twist at the end of the movie. Magic Island is magical. Well, first, we must walk through the island for 6 hours, it seems like. And I compiled some of the footage with music backing for your enjoyment, but the music's a little loud, so just reduce the volume to about half. I'll wait. Okay, your volume figured out. You ready? Here you go. Walking montage!
Drive a little dangerous. I take to my crib, rip it up. Drop the love. Oh,
Jerome, I'm in the house, Moes. I think we need to mess him up again. All right, we're gonna flip it a little bit. Look out.
If you have not completely lost the will to live yet, there is magic. Here you go. Pizza trees and sand sharks, and I think there's a mermaid in there somewhere.
Pepperoni. Excellent. What the heck is that?
Do you have a name?
Yeah, sure. Jack. What's yours?
You may call me Lily. That's what the fish call me.
The fish?
Lily means mermaid. In fish talk.
He's like this with everybody.
And you, you blockhead. Hold your tongue before I file it off.
With what? Hey, could you take me with you? Oh, please, please. I gotta get out of here. I've been stuck with them for 2,000 years. They're like this every day.
Not all the magic is cool trees that grow your favorite food and sand sharks, though. It's also the power to make water look disgusting when it's not magic. What? Oh yeah, and the mermaid can talk to trees. Around here, I lost the will to live, by the way. Somewhere in this movie, there is evil pirates on their tail, and we must fight!
We fight. God bless you, Mad Jack! But not with swords. Hey, then with what?
Don't worry, Gwyn. His plan fails horribly, and you end up fighting with swords 5 minutes later anyways.
The wench with the sword. Let's see how well he can use it.
Say your prayers, you pathetic excuse for a man.
Not bad for a wench. Damn, she's good.
All this back and forth in fighting and kidnapping in capture and tricks and magic means nothing because the bad guys get to the treasure first and totally win. Well, until the director makes a cameo and just says, "Got ya, you actually lose."
Who dares to enter my tomb? I am Carbassus, all-powerful sorcerer of the seven seas.
The good guys accidentally get a piece of treasure out of the vault and the swordsman dude brings it back to his mom so she'll be proud of him. The mermaid inexplicably turns back into a mermaid, but Zachery Ty Bryan does get to kiss a mermaid, so I guess that's kind of cool. I mean, it'd be cooler if it was a real mermaid. Maybe I'll review that documentary about mermaids one day. I'm getting distracted. I want to call him Jonathan Taylor Thomas so fucking bad. Zachery Ty Bryan wakes up, thinks it's all a dream, until he sees his wet jeans. Mom left the meeting early, so I guess she's fucking fired now. He should have kept the treasure, because they're screwed. They're going to have to fire the Haitian chick, and everybody dies. Okay, no one dies, because it's a kids' movie, and people can't die in kids' movies. most of the people in this never did anything again. Gwyn and the swordsman guy never really acted much. The mermaid never acted much. Zachery Ty Bryan's a producer now. The bad guys are Andrew Divoff from Wishmaster and French Stewart. And God, this got rough once I ran out of alcohol. Thank you for watching, and as always, I shall try to do better next time. Here's a clip of a giant stone monster thingy. Oh, don't go away just yet. I forgot yet another subplot. The swordsman, while they're captured, admits to Gwyn that he only brought her on the mission because she's hot. And she gets pissed off for the last half an hour of this movie. Not because that's sexist. Not because he doesn't respect her swordsman skills. But because he waited so long into the movie to tell her. She's pissed off about the timing, not about the sexism. God bless you, kids' movies. Goodbye.